Hello friends, I hope you like my last video that is about validation summary report. If you are having any question, you can ask me in the comment. So in this video, we will discuss about the traceability metrics for computerized system. So friends, my YouTube channel name is Pharma Quality. So please view, like, comment and subscribe my channel to get the knowledge about the pharma quality standards and practices. Now let's understand what is traceability metric. So in simple terms, a traceability matrix is a document that links requirements, that is, you know, requirements which are mentioned in the user requirement specification or functional requirement specification throughout the project life cycle, right? So it establishes a clear traceable relationship between different projects elements, correct? So basically, through this document, we can able to verify the all requirements were met, tested and verified, correct? So now we will discuss what is the advantage of traceability metric. So first is traceability metrics confirms 100% test coverage. That means through this deliverables, we can confirm that the all steps which are mentioned in the URS or FRS have been tested, right? So second is traceability matrix highlights any requirement missing. So through these deliverables, we can identify if any test has been missed which are mentioned in the URS or FRS, and based on the identification, we can take the further action, right? So third is traceability matrix shows the overall defects of execution status with the focus on business requirement. So through this deliverables, we can check the discrepancies observed during the validation at which point. So fourth is traceability matrix helps to analyzing or estimating the impact on the QA team's work with respect to the revisiting or reworking on the test cases. So at the time of review and approval of documents, if any gap is identified, that it can be revisit, or if required, we can rework or retest of that particular test case, right? So these are the some basics advantage of, you know, having the traceability matrix, right? Slide, we will discuss how to prepare a traceability matrix report. So I have taken example to understand how the traceability matrix should be looked like, right? So you can see there will be the serial number, URS ID, FRS ID, requirement description, protocol number and test ID and comment. So there are total 6 column, and you can see if in the first column I have written that URS ID, and in second column the FRS ID, and if FRS ID is not available or FRS document is not applicable for that particular system, you can write it as a not applicable. So for example, I have taken one, you know, installation qualification requirement which is mentioned in URS. So like you can see, the requirement description is hard disk capacity should be minimum 500 GB or above. So here we can, you know, provide the relevant protocol number, that which on which protocol number we have tested this or verified this, you know, description or steps, and along with this we need to provide the protocol number and test ID of that step, correct? And in the next column there is a comment, so you can write any discrepancy or resolution related to this steps. So you can have the one comment option also. And in the next, I have taken an example from the OQ. So there is a requirement which is mentioned in the URS, like system should have the password reset option. So you need to give the protocol number and test ID with respect to this operational requirement which is mentioned into the URS, right? And likewise you can put the comment. And third one is the I've taken example from the PQs, like if your URS said that systems should allow to execution of test as per the requirement. So based on that, you need to provide the protocol number and test ID and the comment, and also the at which step in the URS or FRS, if it is applicable, then you need to mention that step ID, right? So likewise, we can prepare the traceability matrix for other requirements which are mentioned in the URS or FRS. So I hope you can understand now. So friends, this is all about the traceability matrix, and in the next video we will discuss about this some other topics. I hope this video will help to better understand what is traceability matrix. Thank you.